everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find the arc length of a polar parametric curve. So in this case, we have a polar parametric curve defined as r equals e to the theta over 2, or 1/2 theta. And we've been asked to find the arc length associated with that parametric curve when theta is between 0 and 4 pi. So in order to find arc length, we're going to use this formula over here for ds, essentially. It's going to give us arc length. So let's go ahead and just start writing our formula, and we'll talk about what we get as we go. So to find arc length, ds, we're going to take the integral on the range a to b. Well, a and b are defined by the range here, 0 and 4 pi, so we're going to be evaluating from 0 to 4 pi. And then we're going to be taking the square root here of dr over d theta, which is the derivative of the function r. R equals e to the theta over 2. So to take the derivative of that function, remember, we'll just call it r prime. When you're taking the derivative of something here with the exponential number e, we just have to multiply the coefficient on the variable in the exponent out in front. So in other words, because this is e to the theta over 2, which is the same thing as e to the 1/2 theta, we bring that 1/2 down in front for the derivative, so we get 1/2 e to the theta over 2. And that's our derivative. So let's go ahead and plug that in here. So 1/2 e to the theta over 2, and according to our formula, we're going to square that. And then we add to that r squared. And r, of course, for here, this is r. We're going to define that again by our original equation for r. So we'll end up with e to the theta over 2, and we're going to square that as well. This is all going to be under our square root sign, and then we're going to put d theta out here, of course. So now this is just a matter of simplifying what's inside of our integral, and then evaluating on the range 0 to 4 pi. So to simplify what's inside the integral, first we're going to square what's under the square root sign, because we have two things that are squared, so we'll have the square root. So to evaluate this part here, to square that, we'll get 1/4, that 1/2 squared is going to be 1/4, and then e to the theta over 2. Remember that e to the theta over 2 is the same thing as e to the 1/2 theta. Well, when we square that, right, e to the 1/2 theta times e to the 1/2 theta, because the bases of these exponential terms here, the bases are the same, they're both e, that means we can add the exponents. So 1/2 theta plus 1/2 theta gives us 1 theta, which obviously we can drop the 1, it's redundant, we just get theta. So e to the theta over 2 squared is just going to be e to the theta. So we'll end up with e to the theta there. Then we have this e to the theta over 2 squared again, so that we already know is also going to be e to the theta, and we've got our d theta out here on the end. So now we can go ahead and combine these two terms into one fraction underneath the square root sign. Let's go ahead and make the second term. We'll put a 4 over 4 in front of it to get a common denominator with our first fraction. So because our first fraction was over 4, we want to put the second term over 4, but without changing this integral at all. So in order to do that, we need to put 4 over 4, which of course is just equal to 1. So now we end up with 0 to 4 pi. We end up with the square root of 5/4, right? 1/4 plus 4/4 is 5/4. So 5/4 e to the theta, d theta. Now we can take these separately. Because the 5/4 is out in front of the e to the theta, we can take the square root of that separately from taking the square root of e to the theta. And we can move that out in front since it's a constant and it's a coefficient on this e to the theta. So we'll end up with the square root of 5, because we can't really take the square root of 5, but the square root of 4 is 2. So we end up with the square root of 5 over 2. That's this part here, and it moves out in front of the integral. Then we're going to have the integral from 0 to 4 pi, and all that's left now is the square root of e to the theta, d theta. Well, remember, we found earlier e to the theta by adding or by multiplying e to the 1/2 theta and e to the 1/2 theta together. So we know that the square root of e to the theta is e to the 1/2 theta. So we'll end up with square root of 5 over 4. This is going to be ds equals, square root of 5 over 2 times what we get when we take the integral, right? The square root of e to the theta is e to the 1/2 theta. And we're going to be evaluating this on the range 0 to 4 pi. So now, to evaluate, we're going to plug in our upper limit of integration first, 4, then we'll subtract, and then plug in the lower limit of integration. So we'll get ds equals the square root of 5 over 2 times e to the 4 pi times 1/2 is going to be 2 pi. Then we'll subtract and plug in our lower limit of integration, 0. We'll end up with the square root of 5 over 2. 0 times 1/2 is just 0. E to the 0 is 1. So we end up with 1 there. So now, to get our final answer for arc length, we can factor out square root of 5 over 2, and we'll simply end up with e to the 2 pi minus 1. And that's it. That's our final answer. So that answer represents the arc length of the polar parametric curve e to the pi over 2 on the range 0 to 4 pi when theta is between 0 and 4 pi. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next one.